So this is the beginning of a big game of hungry numbers getting set up. Is getting all the numbers in order to start playing. From 0 all the way to 10, and I think your 3 might be backwards too. Yeah, there you go. Okay, and now you can take any from any of these piles and feed the numbers. If you also want to turn them around, that's fine. Or pick them anyway. This game is great for practicing counting, even some very hard arrangements.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
And since Dolly has played this game, she knows not to double count the ones in a circle. She remembers which one she started on and can stop at that one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
But this is a great game both for counting a one-to-one correspondence, which is knowing that one dot goes with one number in the counting sequence, and especially for cardinality, knowing that the final number you count is the total number it is. And it's also great for subitizing, which is when you can recognize certain arrangements as being a number, and you can tell she just saw that the full tens frame is 10, she didn't have to count that one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
It's interesting. Somehow, Dahlia knew without counting that 7 that it was 7, and she knows without counting that 9 that it is 9. It's very interesting to try to think of how a child might do that. Sometimes they need to count one by one. Sometimes they're starting to figure out patterns in the number, in the numbers and the arrangement of the dots that allow them to just know where the things go. You can see she's getting more sophisticated in the way she is seeing the dots. And it's allowing her to make sense of them without always having to count one by one, which is, it's really interesting. I always find it just fascinating to say, what's happening in this child's head that allows them to see these things without having to count one by one? Sometimes it's just about recognizing the thing. Sometimes it's about being accustomed to the patterns. That time she counted by 2s. This one's so tricky. Hold on. Could you
do that count again? This one's so tricky. She's trying to be very careful to do it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Uh-huh. So some of these are really designed to be challenging. Hold on, Dolly, could you explain to me how you counted that?
I counted it by twos. 2, 4, 6, 7, because there was only one more left.
Nice. So there's all kinds of new counting strategies happening here. This game just gives her a chance to try out all these different things that she notices and that she's discovering about how these arrangements work.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Oh, I feel like I skipped one. Or like nine.
Remember, you can always keep a finger at your starting one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
At this point, some of them are so familiar that she has no trouble placing them. Even up to five now.
1.
Counting my twos to get 8. Sorry, how many is that?
I counted 2, 4. Oh yeah. 2, 4, 6.
Cool.
Oh, I was putting it in 7.
Wait, what just happened there?